The brain is a muscle, and that's a muscle, and that's a muscle, and they are all muscles.
Hey guys, I'm Chef Dan, and today I'm gonna tell you how you can eat like Chris Hemsworth.
Hey guys, Bob here from Raw Strength and Muscle, and today we're gonna talk about how Chris Hemsworth, AKA Thor from the Marvel movies, is able to stay lean while bulking on 5,000 calories a day. Also, we're gonna talk about how I am able to cut on damn near 5,000 calories a day. All right, so let's look at the clip that's bringing this whole concept up of how much Thor is eating.
Chris would eat sometimes 5,000 plus calories a day to get to the bulking capacity that he needs.
Before we even discuss how many calories Thor is eating to get ready for these movie roles, we gotta discuss the verbiage that this guy's using. You know, I don't know if you guys have ever studied like body language, verbal tonality, verbiage, you know, to tell if a person's lying or telling the truth or what he's thinking or if he's trying to hide something. Let's listen to this clip one more time and pay very good attention this time to the exact words that he uses.
Chris would eat sometimes 5,000 plus calories a day to get to the bulking capacity that he needs.
So if you pay attention to exactly what he said sometimes 5,000 or more calories a day when bulking. So by saying sometimes, he's already saying it's not written in stone every single day he stuffs 5,000 calories of food down his throat, come hell or high water. It is sometimes he will eat up to 5,000 calories or more, okay? So we already know that this is not exactly what he ate every single day. Another thing is at the end he said, when bulking. So let's say that Chris Hemsworth has a 6-month window where he has to prepare for a role. He's not going to be eating 5,000 calories every day. It's gonna be sometimes. And it's also going to be when bulking. So when he starts working out seriously to build mass, to get ready to play Thor, he's not going to, from day one, be shotgunning 5,000 calories down his throat. Number two, this is during the bulking phase. So he'll do that, he'll grow into 5,000 calories a day, okay, sometimes. Then what he's going to do is when he has to kind of like lean out towards the end after he's built up the size, built up the strength, the last several weeks, the last couple months, he'll kind of pull it in a little bit so he leans out and isn't fat for the role. So like I said, right now we automatically know that he's not taking in 5,000 calories a day every single day for 6 months straight. But I'm sure he is eating a hell of a lot of calories, and I'm sure there were times when he ate, you know, 5,000 calories, and I've never seen a picture of him because he's always in social media, 24/7, showing his workout, showing his physique. He never gets fat. So how is it? Well, this is one of the ways that he's able to stay lean while taking in 5,000 calories a day.
So the biggest thing to remember is Chris is massive, 6'3" plus, maybe 6'4". Sorry, Chris, if I get you short.
So Chris Hemsworth is 6'3". That is not a small man. Also, when he was getting ready for his roles as Thor, he said he got around 220 pounds. So a person who is 6'3" tall, 220, is obviously gonna be taking in a hell of a lot more calories than a person who's 120 pounds. Just carrying 220 pounds around, walking around, not even worried about your workouts, but just the metabolism that you need to maintain that weight, you're gonna be taking a lot of calories to move around. And then on top of that, you're going to be working out. But how is it that I was able to take in damn near 5,000 calories a day and not get fat and actually get leaner? Because look at this. Chris Hemsworth is 6'3", 220. Chris Bob Roberts is 5'9" and got down to 189 pounds on damn near 5,000 calories, okay? Actually, I'm 5'8 and a half, but my girlfriend is 5'8", so instead of rounding it down, she has me rounded up to 5'9", so it sounds better for her boyfriend to be at least an inch taller than her. But anyway, the point is, he is a big man, I'm not as big. How was I able to take in so many calories and cut? Now I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna show you first my diet. How exactly did I take in so many calories? Now, I was doing what I call the anaerobics diet, which is a carb timing or a targeted ketogenic workout. Basically, I took in carbs before and after my workout, okay? So between my pre and post workout shakes, that was a total of 830 calories. Okay, I started off eating chicken and almonds, and then after that I went up to eating ground beef, like 80% lean, fatty ground beef with cottage cheese. At the end, I was getting so goddamn hungry, and I was cutting weight so goddamn fast that I was actually taking in 80% lean, which is very fatty, ground beef, and I had a half a cup of cottage cheese, and then I threw in a half a cup of ricotta cheese, okay? So four meals of beef with cottage cheese and with ricotta cheese is 2,760 calories. And at night, I either had Greek yogurt with some whey protein mixed in, I call it protein pudding, or I had a casein protein shake. So all in all, total for those seven meals was 4,598 total calories. And I not only was not getting fat, I was dropping weight quickly, and I was fucking starving. I went down from like a little bit over 200 down to low 190s. I got down, I think the lowest was 189 pounds, and I was starving on well over 4,500 calories a day at 5'9", 189 pounds. How is it? Well, similar to the way that Chris Hemsworth trains, I do a combination of like agility and explosive training with heavy strength training. So what I would do for a lower body workout is, let's say I would do 20 rep squats with heavy ass weight. Then I would do five sets of five reps with heavy ass weight on the trap bar. Then afterwards, I would do squat tucks, right? You know, squat down, touch the ground, jump back up again, bring my knees to my chest for sets of 10 with a short 30 second break in between. And I would do burpees for sets of 10 with a 30 second break in between. Now, like I said, I was not just burning up these calories and not getting fat. I was not just burning up these calories and cutting fat. I was fucking starving. I was literally in a panic because I would eat my meal and still be starving. So it kind of shows you how many calories you can burn when you do this kind of workout. Like I said, I'm building all kinds of muscle, which is great. But at the same time, I'm also just burning so many calories because of all the explosive cardio that I'm doing, the short, high-intensity interval cardio I'm doing. So that was it. I would do upper body, heavy weights, you know, weighted dips, weighted pull-ups, rows on rings, etc. And I would finish up with doing upper body plyometrics as intervals. Lower body, like I said, I would do like heavy weights. Then I would go ahead and do like jumping exercises, burpees and squat tucks. I had a 2 days a week I did abs, heavy weighted abs. Then I would do a half an hour of jump rope intervals where I just kill it, take a short break, kill it, take a short break for the entire half an hour. Burns up massive amounts of calories, gets you very lean while building strength. So like I said, this is actually similar to what you see Chris Hemsworth doing, okay? I'm not saying his center point or center fit app, whatever he calls it, where he sells these workouts. I'm talking about when you see him actually working out. Sometimes he'll be lifting weights. Sometimes he'll be boxing against the bag. Sometimes he'll be boxing against mitts. Sometimes he'll be doing sprints or have like a resistance band, running, sprinting against the resistance band. He'll always be doing a combination of some kind of an explosive movement like boxing or sprinting or jumping. He'll also combine that with heavy ass weights. So when you do this, you actually do need the kind of nutrition, just not the protein and everything, but the pure calories you need to be able to fuel these workouts and, more importantly, fuel your recovery, okay? It's kind of like there are two different ways that you can cut. You can either move less and eat less, or you can move more and eat more, okay? Most people move less and eat less. They cut their calories in their diet so that they're starving, and then they don't feel like doing any cardio, they don't feel like moving. The other way is the way that I do it and the way that he apparently does it, where you actually eat more, okay? So what I'll do is I will go into a cut, get leaner and leaner and leaner, and during the entire time when I'm getting leaner and leaner, I will be increasing my calories, because think of it like this. Most people cut their calories, okay, as they go into a cut. With me, let's say I increase my calories by 300 in my diet, but I burn an extra 500 calories because I increase the amount of explosive cardio I'm doing. Well, in this case, obviously, you know, 500 calorie increase in the burn, 300 calorie increase in the intake means I'm still 200 calories in the hole. I'm burning 200 more calories more because I'm increasing my energy output more than my energy intake. The way that I really like about this is at the end of a cut, I'm automatically at maintenance calories, okay? I'm not starving myself to the point that I have to reverse diet out of it. Nothing wrong with that. It's fine to cut like that. I've got programs where you can cut like that too. But my preferred method of body recomposition is doing more. And as you get leaner, as you start to get more hungry, as you need more fuel to fuel your workouts, you eat more and more and more. So at the end of your cut, you're actually at maintenance calories. You don't have to worry about rebounding and gaining fat. You also don't have to worry about reverse dieting so you don't get fat, okay? Anyway, appreciate it. Appreciate you guys watching this video. Definitely subscribe if you haven't. Let me know if you have any questions that you'd like me to answer or any topics you'd like me to cover in future videos. If you haven't subscribed, do that. If you haven't clicked that little bell icon so it notifies you when I put out a new video, do that. Aside from that, thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.